Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, we have seen that in the case of analysis of free convection or natural convection, the role of non-dimensional numbers are paramount. Now let us use those non-dimensional numbers to solve your problem. The problem in this case that they are given is again on flow through pipe. Now there are two cases. One, when the pipe is kept vertical, and then if the pipe is kept horizontal. For both the cases, the exercise of finding the Grashof number is different. Now in this problem, first of all let us read the problem. The problem says a steel pipe of outer diameter 0.15 meter lies 2 meter vertically and 8 meter horizontally. Now this is really interesting. They have given a steel pipe whose outer diameter they have given, and that they have said that this pipe is made in such a way that it remains 2 meter vertically and 8 meter horizontally. So it stays in a bit of L shape. In a large room with an ambient temperature of 30 degrees Celsius, so they have given us the ambient temperature. The pipe surface is kept at 250 degrees Celsius. The temperature of the surface of the pipe is given, that is 250 degrees Celsius, and its emissivity is 0.6. So the emissivity of the surface is given as 0.6. Estimate the total heat loss due to convection and radiation. As the emissivity is given, we need to find out the heat transfer by radiation itself from the pipe to the surrounding. The property at film temperature is given as K as 0.035 watt per meter Kelvin. Then the kinematic viscosity is given as 27.8 into 10 raised to minus 6 meter square per second. The Prandtl number is given as 0.684. Then they have given a relationship, one for the turbulent flow and the other for the laminar flow. If the flow is a turbulent, then the Nusselt number is given as 0.13 Grashof into PR raised to 1 by 3. If it is a laminar flow, then they are given as 0.53 Grashof into Prandtl number raised to 1 by 4. This was asked in December 14 in case of Mumbai University. Now let us start solving this problem. This is a L-shaped pipe. So let us start drawing the L-shaped pipe. Let us say this is a 2 meter vertical pipe, and let's say the height of this is 2 meter and this horizontal pipe is, they have given this as 8 meter. Now let us say this is the L-shaped pipe that they have given. Then it is kept inside a certain room. Let's say the temperature of room be T infinity, and let us say the temperature of pipe is TS. They have given us that T infinity is 30 degrees Celsius and T surface is 250 degrees Celsius. So obviously I can easily write down that the surface is at higher temperature as compared to the freeze time air. Now apart from this, they have given that the emissivity of the surface is 0.6, and then they have given the various properties of the air which we are not going to write down. But apart from this, they are asking us to find out the total heat loss. So obviously we can say that the total heat loss in this case is, let's say, Q dash T. They are asking us to find out the Q dash of T. So now this Q dash of T is a product of Q dash due to radiation plus Q dash of convection when the pipe is kept vertical. So let us write C V plus Q dash again due to convection, but in the second case when the pipe is kept horizontally. So we need to find out this 3 heat transfer rate to know the total heat transfer rate that is coming out from this pipe. So let us start with the vertical pipe. Now we know that first thing that one must know is the characteristic length. Now in case of vertical pipe, my characteristic length will be the height of the pipe. So that is 2 meter. Then the beta value is obviously the mean temperature. Now in this case, the mean temperature is nothing but 30 plus 250 divided by 2. So that we are getting as 280. So that is 140 degrees Celsius. And beta is obviously 1 upon Tm in Kelvin. So this we are getting as 1 upon 140 plus 273. So I can write down this beta as 1 upon 143. Now again this is in Kelvin. Again we need to first of all find out the Grashof number. The Grashof number is given by rho g beta delta t L cube upon nu square. Now here we need to simply put the numbers. The density of the fluid that they are given is, we will incorporate this density with the value of nu. So let us start with the g. This is 9.81. The beta value is, obviously it is there in the denominator, that is 413. The delta t in this case is 250 minus 30 into L. Now in this case my L is obviously 2 meter, so 2 cube, and in the denominator we are left with nu square. Now what is the value of nu that they have given? They have given this as 23.07 into 10 raised to minus. Now again if I solve for this, then we are getting the value as 5.41 into 10 raised to 10. Now obviously this number is more than 10 raised to 9, so that will make my flow as a turbulent flow. Now for the turbulent flow, the relationship that they are given is 0.13 Grashof into PR raised to 1/3. Now this thing they have given us in the problem itself. Now the Prandtl number is given, that is 0.69. The Grashof number we have already found out. If I put it in this equation, then we can find out the value of H, because Nusselt number itself is given by H L upon K. The K is known, the L is 2 meter, we can find the value of H. So let us do that. H L upon K is given as 0.13. 5.41 into 10 raised to 10 multiplied by 0.684 is the Prandtl number that they are given, raised to 1/3. Now in this case the value of L is 2 meter and the value of conductivity is 0.035. So if I substitute in the main equation, I can easily find the value of H. So we are getting this as 7.52 watt per meter square. Okay. The next step is obviously finding the value of heat transfer rate by convection for vertical pipe. This is given by the Newton's law of cooling, that is H A delta T. H is again 7.52. My area in this case is again the surface area. The surface area is pi. The diameter that they have given is 0.15. and the length of the pipe is 2 meter. So this makes my surface area, and the delta T is obviously 250 minus 30. Again everything is known in this case. I can easily find out the value of heat transfer rate by. So the heat transfer rate by the plate or the pipe when it is vertical is given by 1558.4. Now let us do the similar exercise for the horizontal pipe. Now again for the orbital find Grashof number, which is given by rho g beta delta t upon nu square. So again, if I start solving for the given, then the Grashof number that we are getting, again in this case also, please try and understand, everything is known. The beta value is again 1/413, delta t is 250 minus 30. In this case, my L will be the diameter, because my characteristic length for the horizontal pipe is nothing but the diameter. Now this is the most important thing that need to be understood in this case, that the characteristic length for the same pipe when it is horizontal is different and when it is vertical it is different. So when it is horizontal, it is given as the diameter. So we'll put this as L as diameter, that is 0.15 meter. If I put it again, the value of mu is given, so we can easily find the Grashof number. In this case, the Grashof number that we are getting is 0.22 × 10⁸. In this case, the Grashof number that we are getting is 0.22 × 10⁸. Now we can easily make it out that this is less than 10⁹. Since it is less than 10⁹, we can say that the flow must be a laminar flow. Now for a laminar flow, they have given us the Nusselt number. The Nusselt number is given as 0.53 gr into pr raised to 1 by. Again, let us write the Nusselt number, that is h, instead of l, write the d, l upon k. Here the characteristic length is given as the diameter, is equal to 0.53. Now gr number is 0.22 × 10⁸. The Prandtl number is 0.68. Now this raised to 1/4. Here again, we'll put the value of diameter as 0.15 meter and the thermal conductivity as 0.035 watt per meter Kelvin. If I do so and if I put it in this equation, I can easily find the value of h. So in this case, the value of h that we are getting is, now this is obviously given for the horizontal, so let me write this hh. This was for the vertical pipe. So the hh that we are getting is 7.73 watt per meter square Kelvin. So we have easily found out the heat transfer coefficient when the pipe is kept horizontal. We know again that q dash is given as h a delta t. Now in this case, we are going to consider this h as for the horizontal. So this is again 7.73 into the surface area. When my pipe is horizontal, my surface area is again pi d into l. So pi, the diameter is 0.15 and the length is 8 meter is what they have given. And then the delta d. Delta d is again 250 minus 30. So again, the value of q dash, now this we have written this as q dash of convection when the pipe is kept horizontal. So ch, convection for horizontal pipe. So at the end of this, we are getting this value as 6407.8 watt. So we have successfully find the value of q dash when the pipe is kept vertical and the value of q dash when the pipe is kept horizontal. Similarly, the q dash due to radiation is given as by the Stiefel-Boltzmann rule, the Stiefel-Boltzmann constant into the area into the Ts minus T infinity raised to 4. So Ts raised to 4 minus T infinity raised to 4. This need to be multiplied by the emissivity. Now this value is again 5.67 × 10⁻⁵, 5678. The area in this case need to be considered for horizontal and vertical. So this can be easily written as pi into d, that is 0.15, and length will be 1 for the horizontal and then for the vertical. So for vertical it is 2, and for horizontal it is 8. So we need to, we can write this as 10 itself if you want. This multiply by the TS. Now TS is 250. Now let us write down in the Kelvin. So 250 plus 273 raised to 4 minus T infinity, that is 30 plus 273 raised to 4. Now this entire exercise need to be multiplied by the emissivity that they are given as 0.6. Now if we are doing this, then the value of Q dash of R we are getting is 10637.82 watt. So as I have written previously, the total Q dash is Q dash for convection when the plate is horizontal, plus Q dash of convection when the plate is vertical, plus Q dash of radiation. So let us put the numbers 1558.4 plus 6407.8 plus this number, that is 10.10637.8. So if I do this algebraic exercise, the total heat transfer that we are getting is 18604 watt. So almost 18 kilowatt is the amount of heat transfer by the pipe. So that is what they were asking us to find the total heat loss due to convection and radiation. So this we have got to around 18 kilowatt. Now in this problem we have tried to understand the use of characteristic length and the use of various non-dimensionless number to find the heat transfer coefficient and hence to find the heat transfer. Thank you for watching this video. Please stay tuned with Ekeeda and subscribe to Ekeeda. Thank you.